Welcome to the Medical Device School. Here is Munir Lazizi from easymedicaldevice.com. And today we continue to discuss with Eric Wolbrecht about the economic operators. And the question that I have for Eric now is, who is controlling the economic operators? As we have the manufacturers, last time we discussed about that, we said that we have the manufacturers, the authorized representative, the importer, the distributor, and some service providers or procedure pack creators. So then who is controlling all these companies? So Eric, what can you say about that?
Well, in the end, to use a Lord of the Ring paradigm, the ring that binds them all is the competent authority, because the competent authority is responsible for enforcement of the MDR. And since the economic operators have their own obligations, all of them need to answer to the competent authority. So if the manufacturer is naughty, he can get in trouble with the competent authorities. If the authorized representative is naughty, same thing for importer and distributor. But these parties also have interdependencies, because the authorized representative has a move from the manufacturer. So the manufacturer will control the authorized representative partly that way. On the other hand, the authorized representative has responsibilities, right? Because he must monitor compliance of the manufacturer. So he will control the manufacturer that way.
Yeah.
The importer has obligations to do, all of these things. The middle one is the importer.
Okay.
And like this. I'll make sure that this thing is also provided.
Yeah, we put that on the show notes for people that are listening to that. So we have Eric that is showing just a flow chart about all these economic operators.
Yeah, so the importer has to do all these things, like put his own name on the device, check whether the device is registered in UDMED, whether a UDI has been allocated. All of these things. So these are things that they are responsible for towards the authorities, maybe also through to the manufacturer through the contract, and the same thing for the distributor for their responsibilities.
But for manufacturers, so we know that a notified body has to go and audit the manufacturers every year. They have to check what they are doing and if they are compliant. Is there a similar thing with distributors, importers, or authorized representatives, like somebody that is coming every year to check that they are doing a good job?
No, because the oversight of distributors and importers is based on an ex post basis by competent authorities. That's how the system in the MDR is set up. Except when these are entities that are included in scope of the manufacturer's quality system.
Okay.
Which could happen, for example, if you have a multinational company that has its own importer in the union and has their own distributor, and also does, for example, let's say, does Article 16 operations at distributors, repackaging, translation of IFUs, that kind of stuff, and does that within the scope of their single quality system, then I could envisage that the notified body also checks this at some point, even if it's not strictly necessary for the CE marking.
Okay, so we have those companies that are acting under the MDR, so they have some responsibilities. If they are doing something wrong, so this is the competent authority that will come and maybe audit them with an unannounced audit or something like that.
Yeah, or maybe accompanied by the police, kick in their door and shut down the company. That also happens.
Okay, and specifically for the authorized representative. So the authorized representative is mandatory for manufacturers that are located outside of Europe. You have to mandate those, so we have to have an agreement with them. So those authorized representative, as they are on the scope of the manufacturer that is outside of Europe, who is checking that he's doing also the correct things?
Yeah, those would be the partially would be the notified body, because Article 11 should be part of the so the scope of the authorized representative mandate, and should be part of the manufacturer's quality system, basically how it interacts with the authorized representative. But enforcement-wise, it's the competent authority in the member state in which the authorized representative is established. And what you typically see is that, I know in the Netherlands, for example, where I live, that the competent authority, the healthcare inspectorate, actually really likes it when you've got authorized representatives that have a lot of manufacturers, that they keep them informed about what their activities are, how they do things, how they implement the MDR. So the authorities know what they are dealing with and also have an idea of whether they can actually trust this party to do a good job.
So do you think a good connection between those distributors and the competent authority should be done proactively, or you have to wait that you have a problem to call your competent authority?
Well, yeah, that's of course, it depends. Huh? With authorized representatives, for example, just like the competent authority, you are working with applying regulatory criteria. And sometimes these authorized representatives have questions that they want to ask the competent authority. So what you normally see is that these kind of economic operators already have quite a good working relationship, as it were, with the competent authorities. Distributors much less, especially in countries where distributors are not licensed by the authorities for the activity. And then you typically get situations where there's a vigilance issue, because it turns out that the device has been, that there are sterility issues that are caused by the way the device was treated in the supply chain. And then distributors have the obligation to safeguard these conditions. So then the competent authority, if there's an issue at the hospital, they will just move up the supply chain and they will look at each of these entities where the root cause is. And if it's the root cause at the distributor and if they find out that the distributor always, leaves the devices outside in the sun and in the rain on pallets in the parking lot, yeah, then they have a big problem.
Okay, so I think it's interesting. So just for all the economic operators, so don't think that you are just watched by the manufacturer that is signing maybe a contract with you. You have also the competent authorities and sometimes the notified bodies that can come to your door. So be ready for that. Okay, Eric, so thank you for all those informations and I wish you a nice day.
Thank you.